you hear a lot about the school to prison pipeline. We're gonna go from talking about schools to talking about prisons and the criminal justice system. Obviously, one of the biggest topics being discussed as we're filming this interview nationally. So who is making money off of racial inequity in the criminal justice and prison system?
Yeah, I mean, you know, that has received, you know, a fair amount of attention over the years, what we call the prison industrial complex. But that's really, again, just a small, you know, a small sliver of how folks are making money off this. I mean, there is this reality that we now have more people in prison than there are residents in 15 US states. So housing those people, feeding those people, providing healthcare to those people, transporting those people, that is big, big business. But outside from that, again, in significant part because of ALEC, we also have a lot of large corporations profiting off of very cheap or sometimes free prison labor. And so we have, you know, incarcerated folks in this country who are doing campaign calls for, you know, Michael Bloomberg's presidential campaign. We have them making actually like wow. US flags. There are incarcerated folks in this country who are picking cotton. So in the field. So that's certainly a big part of it. But also, you know, tough on crime, these tough on crime strategies have been a big political winner for many years. So it really has been used to divide the electorate and it allows the ultra wealthy to have their preferred politicians win more often. So it's been very effective in that way too. But the other thing that I spent a lot of time talking about in the book that we have to account for is that it is, what they found is that it is cheaper to dehumanize people through things like mass criminalization and incarceration than it is to meet people's basic human needs. And so that's a wealth accumulation strategy in a, you know, morally bankrupt way, but it is. And so those are things that if we're ever going to create a truly just society that we have to confront.
Yeah. Well, look, I know in your book, you also go into how we defeat what you identify as Goliath. I'm sure that we can't touch on all of that, but what's one thing that we could do to fight back against admittedly incredibly well-funded, powerful, politically connected opponents who have a multi-decade advantage in multiple different industries? It seems like a pretty big challenge.
It is, and you know, but I do think it's doable. And you know, I'm frankly actually very excited about what's been happening over the last 10 months. I think, you know, the movement being built can do this, but we all have to recognize that there's really only one effective counterweight to the power of this kind of organized wealth, and that's the power of organized people, right? So to resist this agenda and advance one that's more favorable to low income, working class and middle class folks, we need to build people powered organizations. So one thing I talk about in the book is, you know, maybe the best thing that any one person can do is to really invest their time, their energy, and any money that they have into grassroots racial justice base building organizations. There are hundreds of these organizations around the country who are doing amazing work, who are really leading this effort, but they're often frequently severely under-resourced relative to their opposition. So they need help in lots of ways. And so I would encourage all of your viewers to help out with those organizations any way they can. And I include a list in the book of some of the ones that I know and have worked with, and also on the website, richthankstoracism.com. That's a place to start, but there are many, many more that folks should really get involved with.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, if you're watching this interview and you'd like to find out more, the book we're discussing is Rich Thanks to Racism, How the Ultra Wealthy Profit from Racial Injustice. And I want to thank Jim Freeman for joining us and talking about the book. Really do appreciate your time.
Thank you, John. Really appreciate you.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.